Welcome to the Astro Room, once again, your very own portal to the cosmos. In this video, we are going to do a brief tutorial on how to find the once-in-a-lifetime Coronae Borealis, the nova, the trending, explosive, absolutely what we're all waiting for. And the reason why I'm doing this video is because some of us have certain telescopes that might not have it in their sky catalog, or at least it seems like we don't, and then we don't know how to find it. Let's get straight to it. If you don't know what I'm referring to when I'm mentioning Coronae Borealis, by now, if you do not know, there is a video that I will put in the description where I talked all about it, and you can check it out once you're done watching this video. What we're going to do is find Coronae Borealis in our smart telescope, in particular the Seestar S50. How do we find this? First of all, if we put in the search bar, and all of you should know how to go to the search bar by now, but I'll show you. You're going to go to your Sky Atlas, and you're going to click on Objects, and then you're going to click on Search. When you go here and actually type in T Coronae Borealis, nothing starts coming up. So you can't find it. It's also known as TCRB. You also cannot find it. So it's also known as the blaze star. Cannot find it. So how can we do this? How can we do this? Here's a way that we can figure this out easily. Now, if we open up another app called the Sky Guide app, this is an app for iOS devices in particular, we can search here for the blaze star. Keep it in mind that the blaze star is also another name for this nova that will explode soon, your new nova in the night sky. That's exactly what we're referring to in the Coronae Borealis constellation. And it's named Corona because it looks like a corona. Corona for the Latin word and Spanish word meaning crown or wreath or garland, okay? So if you notice, if you live in dark enough skies, when you look up, you will actually see this shape. You will see this form. The brightest star out of all of them being Alpheca. And how can we find then Coronae Borealis? We know it's also known as the blaze star. Okay, star in Coronae Borealis, because this is the one that's going to explode very soon. Okay, it's got different catalog numbers, different IDs as well. Most commonly known as blaze star or the TCRB, T Coronae Borealis. This is where it's going to appear in this area right here. And as we saw earlier in the Seestar catalog, if you type in T Coronae Borealis, you cannot find it. You cannot find it. So how do we get to it? So what we're going to do is find another object, prominent object, or popular enough for it to be in the Seestar catalog, another deep space object that's in this area to be able to find the Coronae Borealis, the nova, okay? And one way we can do that is if we look at Stellarium, you will see that in Coronae Borealis, Stellarium is another sky guide type of app. It's a sky, has your sky catalog. You can type in any object in here and it'll find it for you. And it's on a web browser. And you'll notice there's another object near Coronae Borealis. This is IC4587. And guys, we're going to want to monitor this star because it's going to appear in the night sky at any moment now, until September of 2024. So we want to make sure we start becoming familiar with this area of the night sky so it'll be easy for us to spot it, to look for it with our smart telescopes, with our Seestar, and we can monitor it perhaps once a week or even more than that. Once or twice a week, if you have a clear night, look out for this nova, because remember, if you go out to your night sky right now, you will not see the blaze star, right? So this is a new star that's going to appear. You will see all these other stars, but you won't see the new one. And that's what we're waiting for. That's what we're waiting for it to appear. So if you notice here, there's another object called IC4587. This object is actually a galaxy. Okay, and we know this by also checking the SkyGuide app. Going back to the SkyGuide app, we find IC4587, which is an elliptical galaxy. And this is, you see how it's in the Coronae Borealis constellation? Okay, this would be our next best bet. Does the Seestar have this object? Because if it has this object, this galaxy, then we know the blaze star, the Coronae Borealis that we're waiting for it to erupt, is going to be right near it. Did you notice that? They're right near each other. Okay, just like how we saw it in the other app in Stellarium app. So that's what we're going to want to do. And you notice your prominent star here, Alpheca, you come down 1, 2, 3. Your blaze star is right there. This is all near each other. Okay, so that's what you're going to look at in the night sky. You're going to literally see these points here, these stars. And right underneath this one, you're going to see, that's where you're going to want to get familiar with to look for the blaze star. And let's go to our Seestar catalog now. Okay, so we mentioned it's named IC4587. It's there. That's what we want. That's exactly what we want. So we can now click on center. So here we have it, IC4587. Literally can't even see it almost, but it's there. And there it is. You see that? We're going to click on it. And we can sync it too. We can sync it if we want. And that's IC4587. So we know Coronae Borealis, T Coronae, the blaze star, is going to be right up here from how we were looking at it in the SkyGuide catalog and in Stellarium, right? So, and if you zoom out, here we have it. Here we have the full deal. And you see the crown? That's the constellation. Coronae Borealis. And there's the main prominent star. So near this object right here, which is a galaxy, it's a galaxy, folks, then we can find Coronae Borealis. And that's it. That's how you can look this up on your own with your Seestar, with your Seestar catalog. And make sure you're making yourself familiar with the night sky as you learn how to use this, learn how to navigate it. See if you can look at it with the naked eye. You should be able to if you live in dark enough skies. You should see this is pretty prominent. You should be able to see this